Hello, welcome back. In this section of the lecture, we are going to look at the longitudinal dynamics modeling of a car to model, simulate and control the system. So before diving into the topic, I would like to give you a short background on modeling of a system. System modeling is the first step in digital validation and analysis of your system. You need a working model which can represent the dynamics of the system based on the input-output parameters of the system. In simple words, it is a set of equations which represent the input-output relationship of the system or mechanism. In math language, creating output as a function of input, y equal to f of x. This model can be simulated for specific period of time, say 0 seconds to 10 seconds, and a time step of 0.01 seconds. So the time step is inversely proportional to accuracy. Lower the time step, better the accuracy. But your simulation time is increased. As you lower the time step, the total simulation time increases since more computations are done. Let us look at an example how the time step variation changes the number of computation and thereby increases the simulation time. If we consider a system running from 0 seconds to 10 seconds with a random input and the time step of 0.01 seconds, we can calculate the number of steps using this formula. N time minus start time by the time step, which is here in our case we get 1000 steps to be calculated. And if we consider the time step to be 0.1 seconds, we get 100 steps. So this is obviously faster and the computation time is 10 times different, 10 times increased in the first version, 0.01 seconds. So this is how the time step influences the computation time. Let us consider the results of model simulation data represented as graphs. This graph shows how step size affects the total simulation time and accuracy. Coming back to the longitudinal dynamics of the car. We are going to look at the simple acceleration model of the car, that is, an equation or a function which can calculate how far a car accelerates as the accelerator pedal position is varied. As per our previous knowledge about modeling, it should be acceleration equal to function of pedal position. This is the starting point of modeling of the longitudinal dynamics of the car. The first part is to find equations of motion which represents the dynamics of the system. For this part, we need to draw the free body diagram and understand what are the inputs and outputs for the system. Then form the governing equation and find the relationship between the input and the output of the system. That rounds up the topic of modeling the system. Let's see how it is done. Longitudinal dynamics of a car refers to the forces and motion in x-axis, the driving axis. The first step to derive the equations of motion is to draw the free body diagram of the system to understand the inputs, outputs to and from the system. In the free body diagram, system is considered as a box which receives input, processes it, and gives output. For longitudinal dynamics of a car, input is the pedal position, which is represented as theta of t in percentage. And output is the acceleration of the car, which is integrated to get the velocity and further integrated to get the displacement s of t. Second step is to define the constants of the system. In this model, we have mass of the car and calibration factor. Calibration factor is a simplified version of dynamics involved in the conversion of accelerator pedal position change into vehicle acceleration. Derivation of this factor is explained in the equations of motion derivation part in this lecture. Specifying input variable and output variables are the next step. Theta of t is the input variable with unit of percentage, and s of t is the output variable, which is represented in meters. Deriving the equations of motion is the final and a very important step. As I've informed earlier, I'll explain the calibration factor here. Change in the accelerator pedal position is directly proportional to the force produced to accelerate a vehicle. Theta into a factor is equal to force, and the factor C is equal to force by theta, which is in the units Newton per percentage. Coming back to the equations of motion, the definition for calibration factor is that the force produced to propel the vehicle for unit change in the accelerator pedal input theta of t in percentage. Fc is the force produced internally by the engine based on the change in theta of t, which is the accelerator pedal position change. Due to this force, we get a change in motion in car. Force produced in the car starts moving with an acceleration based on the net force. And this can be calculated using the formula force is equal to mass into acceleration. Considering that we have an equilibrium condition, Fc is equal to Fr, which means force due to the change in throttle is equal to the net force in an ideal condition. Hence C theta is equal to ma, and we need to find the acceleration, because with acceleration we can find the velocity and in turn the displacement. So based on this equation, acceleration is equal to C theta by m, and velocity is equal to the integration of acceleration, and the displacement is equal to the integration of velocity. To summarize, acceleration is equal to C theta by m, displacement is the double integration of acceleration. As a takeaway for this equation derivation, we have a car with a mass, say 2000 kilograms, and calibration factor C, say 100 kilograms per percentage, and we need to calculate the displacement S. So the equations of motion is acceleration C theta by m, acceleration can be represented as S double dot, and S is the displacement, which is double integration of C theta by m. These equations can be represented into a block diagram format, which can be directly converted into a Simulink model. In the next chapter, let us look at how to convert these derived equations into a Python model and simulate it.